Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am sharing an update on Frankie. We've had her for a year now. And so we're just going to share our journey the last year, some of our favorite things that we have for her, and go over some questions that I get frequently about her breed. So if you want to know more about that, then just keep watching. So first of all, before we jump too far into the video, thank you to Molly and Stitch for sponsoring this video. They are a dog accessory brand located in Austria, and they have some pretty cool things. So I'm gonna share a couple of things that we got from them. It's just super great quality and just like taking your dog accessories to the next level. So we got a leash and a collar, and for reference, this is the Butter collection. There's a couple of different ones. So when you go on to look, just for reference, this is also a size large, and her collar is a size large as well. It has their name right here imprinted. The quality is just so good. And we also, the option for the hardware we got was brass. I think there are a couple of options for that as well. And then we also got, and I'll take it off so I can show you, but we got a collar for her. And again, this is the Butter collection in a size large as well. And these are just, the quality, you guys, is so good. They're handcrafted in Austria. I'm trying to find where the name is. There you go. And we love them. I just feel like you need a good quality set once they reach their, like, the 1 year mark, or whenever they're done growing, and you don't have to keep buying like bigger sizes. Just a good high quality set is super important. And this link to shop will be in the description. And they also gave me a coupon code so you guys can save some money when you shop too. But we love those. Okay, so this video, I have just like a couple bullet points, and I'm just gonna try not to ramble too much. I could talk about her forever. We love her so much. All right, so I will start with researching a breeder. So we researched breeds for a long time, and we landed on Aussie Doodle because they are good family dogs. She's a good medium size. She's about 50 pounds. She might be at like between 45 and 50, which is what they said she would be, so that's good. And they are just super smart and easy to train. So that's what we wanted. Oh, and she doesn't shed. That was a huge one too, especially for my husband. There's a price you pay for that, which I'll talk about in a while, but those were just the main reasons, or the main things that we wanted in a dog, and we looked for a while. So don't just make an impulse decision and get a puppy that you don't know much about. So do your research, find a good breeder, and then the puppy stage. So what we did was got most everything that we would need beforehand, so when we went to pick her up, we could just drive back home and we had everything pretty much set up. The food, why are you like, she's breathing so hard. The food is another big one. Do your research on food. Do you want to do grain-free? Do you want to do raw, fresh, kibbles? Whatever you feel is best, just go with your gut on that one. But do your research, because there are so many options. We went through a few different ones too. So we, I think the first brand we had was Blue Buffalo. And we went through a couple different formulas, I think, with them. And then we landed, I think, just on the regular Blue Buffalo puppy one. We then tried a fresh brand, which they send to you, and it goes in your freezer, then you thaw for the week. It's way high maintenance, but she loved it, and I do believe in all of the gut health and all of the benefits from that. It was just a little too high maintenance and way too expensive for us, personally. And then we currently use Nutro, which is just, I think, local to our, I think, I don't know, maybe it's a nationwide brand, but it's at our local store anyway. We also love Nulo, and they sound familiar, or sound similar, but Nulo is what we get. They have some really good freeze-dried, like, treat and food toppers that we put on top of her food, but those are both just good, clean brands, with no fillers and ingredients you don't want in your dog food, and for affordable too, especially coming from the raw or the fresh food. So pricey. But if it's in your budget, I'm so for it. I think it's great. A little bit about the puppy stage, because I do get, I would say the majority of questions I get are about the puppy stage, because it's a little wild at first. It's such a short period of time though. It's like 2 months, maybe 4 months that is really hard, and then it just slowly gets easier. And it's pretty easy now. And she was really easy to train. She adapted and adjusted to our family really well. So we're really happy with that. But I think the main questions I get are like jumping, nipping, potty training, and all of those things. It's just a short period of time and they'll get the hang of it. So we have two small children. She's very good with both of them and she loves all of us so much. So we love how just loving she is, and she just wants to be around us and she wants to do what we're doing. We did a lot of positive reinforcement training, just treat training. When she was doing something good, just treat, treat, treat. When she would nip, we would just yelp like one of the puppies in her litter would if she bit them too hard, and it kind of like startles her, redirects. Redirecting is just a huge thing too. So if she would chew on, she went through a phase for a couple of months that she would chew on the kids' toys, and you just redirect and then give her her own toy and show her what she can have. And now she doesn't chew on any of their toys. She might have like a crazy like running around moment where she like picks up one of them, but you just have to tell her, and she does not chew. She's not a chewer. Potty training was pretty easy. We again have two kids, so we weren't just like 100% focus on her all day, every day. And so it took a little bit longer, but she did get the hang of it. Okay, so grooming. I feel like I talk about grooming a lot because it's really important for doodles. And she, for reference, has, well, first of all, she is 75% poodle, 25% Australian shepherd. Her dad was a standard poodle and her mom is an Aussie doodle. So I believe that's F1B. But anyway, so she has, she does not shed at all. Sometimes when I'm brushing her, a couple of pieces will come out with a de-shedding comb. But she does not shed at all. And she has a medium wavy hair. It's not curly and it's not straight. So it's the perfect coat in my opinion, but it also is kind of hard to groom, or it's just a little bit more high maintenance. She has to go in once a month and we have to brush her every single day. So that was something that really is not a big deal to me. I don't mind doing it. And it just takes like 5 minutes or less to brush her fully out. So it's not the big of a deal. But the grooming part is expensive. It's just something you have to fit into your work, into your budget, because it's something that has to be done. Otherwise you'll go 6 months without doing it, and then she'll have to get shaved down to the skin because she's all matted. So just something to keep in mind. That's something that we kind of knew, but it is a little bit more than we were expecting. Oh, I do have a couple of favorites that I was going to just mention while I'm talking through too. This is our favorite brush. I don't even know what kind of brush it is, but it is Burt's Bees. I will have all of these things linked below too, but see how it's like wiry and they're kind of bent. So if you go at the right angle, it really gets the hair good. With these, with any kind of brush, you just wanna make sure you're just going all over and not on the same spot a bunch of times, because this will hurt, like this is sharp. So you just have to be careful with these. But it does work really well. It's the best one that I've had and tried. We've tried a couple of different ones, but this really does get down to the bottom and comb it so that prevent matting. Another thing, because this is related to the grooming, is they pluck the hair out of the ears, which can make them super sensitive. Like, it does not sound pleasant to me at all. So she usually comes home after getting groomed and for a couple of days has sensitive ears. So I've been putting this on it and it really helps. You just want to make sure you don't get it like inside the ear. I just put it on, she would get up a little bit, just right here. Just don't get it too far into her ear. But this is an ointment. It's the Young Living Animal Sense ointment. They have a whole line of animal products. This smells good too, and it's just a blend of a bunch of different, it has mango butter, a bunch of different essential oils, and just regular oils. Just soothing and kind of helps. You can also use this on the pads of her feet. Sometimes I do that if they get really rough, or if we're outside for a long time. It's winter right now, so it's kind of rough out there. Or on like cuts and scrapes, you can use that on too. So that's a good all-purpose type of product. I have an ointment or a balm for the kids too. Like, that those kinds of products are like gold, because you can use them for so many things. Another thing that we have, so Well, first of all, so what I'll talk about next is she doesn't like being alone. She likes being around us at all times. She likes doing what we're doing, and she likes car rides. So if you are the type of person that works or is gone all day, I don't recommend this breed because they are so just like attached to you, which I love, but it might not be for everyone. So something that does help if we have to put her in a crate has been CBD, and we have oils and tinctures, but these are actually treats and she loves them. They're just little peanut butter biscuits, but and it's easier to get like a perfect dosage too, because they each have, I think, just 5 milligrams of CBD. But that helps so much with anxiety, like separation anxiety. It also helps with like joint and inflammation. So it's just such a good, like, all around good thing for dogs too. Just make sure you're using a dog specific one, and just follow the directions on the packaging. But that is something we use and love so much. Okay, what's next, Frankie? Need some whoppies. Okay, so training, I kind of touched on like the potty training, but she has been so easy to train. And we really don't do enough, I feel like, because she is so smart. We have just done the basics and we're pretty happy. She's good. The things that we still need to work on are when people come over that she like is super excited about, she will jump and jump and jump and be so excited for like 5 minutes. But it's still just annoying. Just want her to sit and relax. So that she also barks. We get a lot of packages at the door, so she barks at the UPS man. But again, that's not a huge thing, and I don't mind her barking if someone is walking up to my door. And then what was the other thing? Oh, and the last thing is that she is friends with all of the dogs in our neighborhood, and she loves playing with them, so she will not stay in our yard. And we do have an electric, or like a wireless fence that kind of goes in and out, doesn't work the greatest. So we're gonna do a wire in the ground this spring, and hopefully that works better. But she on her own will not stay in the yard. She is always trying to just go play with her friends. So that's another thing. I just highly suggest a fenced in backyard. It would be ideal. We have a fenced in, like our deck goes out, and she can do that. But as far as like just letting her out, she will run. So training though has been super easy. Those are just things we have to work on still. And once it's super fast to train them, and then they just have it and know it. So I am super impressed. She is very smart. And temperament is the last thing on my list to talk about. I've mentioned it enough, but she's great with the kids. She is zero aggressive. With other dogs too, she's great. We take her to the dog park a lot. Not as much now because it's winter, but she loves playing with other dogs. She is just super playful, very social, and we socialized her a lot. Even though we were in the middle of the pandemic, we did go out. All of our neighbors have dogs, and we went to the dog park a lot. Took her for car rides all the time. Took her to the groomer right away. Don't wait to do that. And so that's really important because they have to get used to this stuff right away. Otherwise, it's going to be harder to train them and get used to all the things that you need to do. But I could talk about her all day. She is perfect to me. My husband probably has another opinion, but she is the perfect dog for us. And we love her so much. We all love her. She has bonded with all of us differently. She loves going on walks with us, and she's just perfect. So if you guys have any other questions that I didn't mention, let me know in the comments. Let me know what you want me to film with her next. I have a couple of things planned, but I just thought it would be fun to share a couple of our favorite things, to share this new Molly and Stitch set we got. You guys should go check them out. Follow them on Instagram too. Again, the link to shop will be in the description. Just so pretty. So much more aesthetically pleasing than so many other things we've gotten. But also, they have a bunch of colors. This isn't the only one. And they have a couple different styles. So if the leather is not your thing, we just wanted something classic that would like match and go with her fur and like our home and stuff. But they have a bunch of colors, so you can go check them out. I think that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching today. Have a good day. Bye.